Don't pay to have your Tacoma TSS sensor recalibrated. You can do it yourself. Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. And that's right, don't pay the dealership to recalibrate your TSS sensor. You know, that pesky thing that's right behind here. Now, what I'm speaking about particularly is if you go ahead and replace your OEM grill with the TRD Pro style grill, either the knockoff or the genuine OEM, if you can get it. And by the way, I have heard that a lot of dealerships won't sell you that grill unless you have a TRD Pro VIN number. So you may have trouble getting an OEM, and that's okay. There are plenty of aftermarkets out there that work just fine. But anyway, I've heard recently from a few people that they've gone ahead and put the TRD Pro style grill on their Tacoma right here and had problems with the TSS sensor, talked to the dealership, and they're wanting to charge them upwards of $700 to recalibrate the sensor to make it work again because they're getting an error message, right? Now, I'm here to tell you, don't do that, or at least try this before you do, right? Now, if you're not familiar with what I'm talking about, on the OEM grill, you, of course, have the Toyota emblem here, and behind that is the TSS sensor. When you put the new grill on, you're going to relocate the sensor from this position down here to this position, right, behind this cover. In doing so, you're changing the orientation of the sensor, right? So I suppose, and I've never had this problem myself, but I suppose, and I know because people have told me, you can get an error message, right? So what does the dealership really do? What does recalibration mean? And I find this to be kind of funny. What they do is they go in and they put some washers or shims behind your TSS sensor. That's assuming you can get them to do it at all. But they go in and they put shims behind the sensor. You know, where the screws go in to hold the sensor in, I believe there are four of them. They'll put some shims in there to change the orientation of that sensor, to point it in a different direction, because obviously you've changed where it is when you put that new grill on. Now, let me hang you guys down behind here, see if I can get you a good shot. You'll see the sensor is located right here, right? Trying to do this looking at the camera right here, right? That's the sensor right here. This silver thing or pewter colored thing that you can see. Let me just pull you around a little bit further. That you can see right there. That's a good shot, I think. So right here is the sensor right there. Now, you'll notice you can see screws in it, right? And there are four of them that I can see now looking at the picture you guys are seeing on the camera. So what you need to do is simply pull out those screws. You may not even have to pull them all out, but pull those screws out and put some washers in behind them. That is going to change the orientation, if you will, or the way that that sensor points. Now, I'm guessing that since, and I don't know this for a fact, it would be trial and error, and maybe somebody will chime in the comment section, but I'm guessing because you've lowered the sensor that you would indeed need maybe to shim the bottom two screws and point it up a little bit because it's looking lower than it was before. Now, you'll be able to tell probably right away when you do this if you've done it right, because obviously the error message that you'll be getting on your screen, it is bright out here, that you'll be getting on your screen will go away. Now, I say don't pay the dealership to do this because I'm assuming that you've probably put this grill on yourself, right? And if you have, then you're intimately familiar with how that sensor fits on your grill. So I wouldn't pay a dealership $700 to do what'll cost you less than $2, maybe less than that, for a couple washers and a little bit of your time. And it's well worth it, I think, to go ahead and try this before you actually take your truck in to have it recalibrated. Recalibration simply means changing the orientation of the sensor, right? Now, there are a couple of other things to consider if you have that error message. Obviously, that you've plugged the sensor in, I've had a couple people tell me that they discovered after they had the air that they forgot to connect the wire. Let me show you that. The wiring obviously would be this plug right down here. Let's see if I can get you guys in there right down here. Make sure you plug that in, and then of course following it up and reconnecting it right here. Because obviously if you don't plug it in, it isn't gonna work. Secondly, make sure you don't have anything in front of the sensor, right? I've had a couple of people tell me that they had some kind of aftermarket bumper with a bar or something on it across here. Obviously, the way the sensor's designed, if anything's in front of it, like a bar on your bumper, it's going to trip this sensor. And I would say that if you have a bumper like that, you can't change the grill because you can't put it behind that bar, right? It's going to see it, it's going to give you an error code or let you know something is in front of the truck, and it's not going to work. Lastly, make sure that if you go with a garnish, and that's this plastic part right here, that you go with the OEM version. There is a number stamped on the back of this garnish, and mine actually came from a site on eBay about 2.5 years ago. But there is a number stamped on the back of that. You can see it in many videos. In my video, I think that when I put it on this truck, I showed you guys what that number is. Just make sure it matches. Because again, if you're going to put something in front of the sensor, it has to be designed in such a manner as to let the radar waves go through. And if that knockoff cover that you get has some sort of metal in it, it's not going to work, and that could be your problem right there. So the areas to check are that the orientation of the sensor is correct, that you don't have anything in front of the sensor, that you have your wiring reconnected, and that you don't have any bar or something like that, as well as the particular type of garnish that could be tripping the sensor itself. Pretty simple and well worth, I think, $700 to go ahead and check those things yourself, right? I mean, you can get a new cover. Let's say you have a non-OEM cover. It doesn't have that part number stamped on it. For less than $60. A far cry from $700 and a day at the dealership. Anyway, I just wanted to get on here, kind of talk about that a little bit, because periodically I get questions, people that are having problems with their sensor, asking me what's wrong, and it's not a simple answer. There could be three or four things. Leave a comment. Let me know. Have you had a problem with yours? And what was your fix? I'd be curious to know. Also, real quick, if you're interested, check out my other channel. It is all about my 2020 Jeep Gladiator over here. Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye.